Every time you play Salmon Run, Mr. Grizz gives you the same four specials. Inkjet, Stingray, Splashdown, and Bomb Rush. They work pretty similar to the way they do in normal battles, except you can only use them twice per run, and you can't recharge them by inking turf. Mr. Grizz tells me a lot of his happy little workers aren't using their specials, or just save them up for a party at the end of Wave 3. It's almost as if they don't know how to properly use them. It's almost as if Mr. Grizz never bothered to train them. I guess that's why I'm here, to officially give you your unofficial training on the Salmon Run specials. So without further ado, let's get started with the one you all probably know how to use, the Splashdown. Splatoon 2's Universal Panic Button, except that's not what these specials are for. They're powerful moves that we can use to make jumping in the water look cool, that we can use to turn the tides of battle. The Splashdown is a particularly powerful one because it can splat most salmonid within its area of effect. Got three stingers lined up on shore, one splashdown later, and the stingers are no more. It works the same against steelheads who have the bubble thing out. You can even jump into and destroy one of the flyfish's buckets, although as cool as it feels to do, it's kind of a waste of the special. The other bosses aren't as easy to panic button on. It's enough to put the brakes on a scrapper and splat them if you're using it from behind, same for the eels. But when faced head on, their armor gives them full protection. And you also can't just splash down and one-shot Drizzlers or Maw, which, come on Nintendo, think of how awesome it would have been to just splash down and splat the Maws that was trying to eat you. Overall, the Splashdown is the easiest special to use. It clears out the area around you, and it's a fast way to refill your ink tank, which is a totally valid reason to use it. Sadly, the special cannot break through armor, and it can be cancelled, so beware of using it when you already have a lot of damage on you. Speaking of breaking through armor, next up we have the Stingray, a special that most players save in case of a mothership appears. It's also commonly used against grillers and a traffic jam of scrappers. That's because this special can pierce through armor and walls. It directly damages the scrapper's driver, can hit through the brella of a Drizzler, and it can even damage Maws while they're underground, although it's really not strong enough to splat the Maws, so you're still better off throwing a bomb at them instead. A full Stingray can splat a steelhead, even if it doesn't have the bubble attack thing out. What is this thing called? I don't know what it's called. But most importantly, it can splat flyfish. You just gotta aim for the middle, exactly like you would with the Grisco Slosher. A lot of times I see this special being used on close range bosses when they kinda get clustered around you like the scrappers and eels. But this special was also amazing against long range bosses too. Got a pesky stinger in the distance that none of your teammates are gonna go splat? Easy, just ray it from basket. Got a lot of flyfish hovering in the sky? Same deal. Got dead teammates, and you're the only one alive! You don't even have to be nearby, thank goodness. The main drawback of using the Stingray is that you're basically a sitting duck. If the turf around you isn't inked, you can easily get splatted by basically everything, and you can't run away. In the case that there's a lot of enemies around, you might want to go to a somewhat safe spot and wait until it's between attacks to pull out your special. And if you see a teammate using Stinger, please stick around them to protect them. You're basically baby. But what if you are low on ink? Then that's where Bomb Rush comes in. I'll get to the good parts in a moment, but first, I'd like to point out that this is probably the worst of the four specials since it can't really do much against the bosses. For example, it takes 3 bombs to splat a stinger, and one isn't even enough to stop a scrapper in its way. These things are so unfazed that it kinda looks like they're playing soccer with your bomb. Eels also work like splash walls, which makes the bomb blow up on impact, but if you hit the guy in the back, it just kinda bounces off, so you can't even do damage to them. They might be effective against Maw and Flyfish, but it does get hard to aim well when things are getting overcrowded and you're spamming the R button, hoping for the best, and you're dead now. So, what is the special good for again? 3 things. 1. It's great for crowd control for lesser salmonids. It's just as effective as clearing out the area as a splashdown, although it is a bit slower. 2. It's a great way to instantly recharge your ink tank in a pinch. And 3. Bombs are a good way to revive your teammates. Also, if it's near the end of a match and you have an unexploded bomb, that counts as your team still being alive. So if you manage to toss one with 3 seconds or less remaining, you'll still survive the wave, even if everyone on your team is dead. Is Dooley Leap a saying, one bomb is all it takes? Now, if we're talking about actually surviving, Inkjet is your best bet. Once launched, you'll be flying high above the lesser salmonids and hungry maw, your only threat being the attacks from the other bosses, except that the jet's actually a good counter to all of them. A blast from the inkjet can one-shot a stinger if you hit the pot in the middle. With good aim, the steelhead is one shot away from dead if it tries to attack. It can also destroy one of the flyfish's buckets. There are, however, two things to keep in mind. You do not fly high enough to avoid the steel eel, but you can jump over with the jet's mini boosts. The second is that it's often hard to see when missiles are flying at you since their landing spots show up on the ground and you probably aren't looking down there. In general, it's a good idea to be moving around with the inkjet while in the air, and also stay in the air. It can lure bosses away from your allies, and don't worry, you can safely fly into the water, which will just cancel your special and then send you back to where you launched from. It's very versatile and I'm not at all biased. And that about covers it. If I missed anything or you have any more questions, please let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to use your specials. You thought I was gonna say subscribe, didn't you? Thank you for 30,000, by the way. But no, seriously, use your specials. Better to make it to wave 3 than have a special to party. Okay, that's it for me. I'm out. Bye, guys.